My dear adorable children of class 4. Children, I welcome you back to my English class. I am Vidya Rani, your English teacher. Children, in the earlier video of mine, I was carrying on with chapter number 6, Saving the Sparrow. That was part 3. Today, in this video, I'll carry on with the same very chapter with part 4. So children, before we start with part 4 of Saving the Sparrow, let us quickly recapitulate what we had done in the earlier video of this very chapter. Okay children, like Hira Lal was a small boy who was going to school. While going to school, he saw a bird which was got stuck in the power line. He tried very hard to save that bird, that sparrow. He told his parents even to save that sparrow, but his parents did not agree with him because it was stuck in the power line, which was very dangerous for the normal people to take that bird from there. Okay, then he rushed to the power station and somehow tried to get help from the people who were working in the power station. He requested, he pleaded everyone there, and the supervisor listened to his words patiently and tried to help that child in saving that sparrow. Up till here, children, we had ended in part 3. Let us carry on with part 4. Put your fingers, children, where am I reading? That is page number 56. Just see, children, the bottom of the page. Okay. He stopped and looked into Hira Lal's sad eyes. Then he said, "Tell me your name, son. Also tell me where you live." He touched the boy's shoulder. "You have a large heart, but it's time for you to return home. It's growing dark outside." Now, the supervisor, okay, the supervisor, he stopped and looked into Hira Lal's, what children? Into Hira Lal's eyes, okay. The eyes were sad, and this boy was trying hard to save that sparrow, okay. Then he said, he asked his name and asked where he was living. He asked his address, children. He touched the boy's shoulder. He touched the boy's shoulder and told that supervisor told that boy, "You have a very large heart inside." Okay. And he even suggested that boy that please return back home because it's growing dark. Okay. Followed. It was growing dark since it was evening time, children, and the dusk had appeared and it was growing dark. Okay. So he suggested that small child to return back home. Whatever he can do will be done by him. Okay. Sad and helpless, Hira Lal returned home. Hira Lal was very sad and was very helpless that he couldn't see that bird. Sometime near dawn, he woke up to loud noises. Okay. When it was dawn time, okay, then what happened, children? He was woken by some noise. He went and slept at home since he was very tensed. Okay. But he heard some noises while he was sleeping. Okay. Oi, Hiralal, come out. Hiralal shot out of the house. His heart was racing. He had seen three men. One of them was Ram Bharose. Okay. Now he heard what noise? Ram Bharose was calling out, Oi, Hiralal, please come out, of your house. See, we have come to save the sparrow. Okay. His heart was racing. Okay. He was very excited from inside. Okay. And was very hopeful that someone has come to rescue the bird. Okay. And when he came out, what did he see, children? Three men were there. There is a power shut down at the station, Ram Bharose explained. They had come with a truck to rescue the sparrow. Now, Ram Bharose, what did he say? That maintenance staff, that there is a power shutdown. Okay, power shutdown has been done for you because you requested to save the sparrow. Okay, and they had come with a truck to rescue the sparrow. They had come with what, children? With a truck to rescue the sparrow. Okay. Hiralal, hurry and jump into the truck. Show us where the sparrow is. Now, Ram Bharose said, come on, come on. Come and jump in the truck. Okay. And show us where the sparrow is. Where the sparrow has got stuck. Okay. Hiralal searched for the bird suddenly. He yelled, a little more to the right, a little more. They were now directly under the power line where the sparrow was trapped. Now Hiralal started searching for the bird and suddenly he yelled. Yelled means what, children? He shouted. Shouted and said, a little more to the right. Please shift a little more to the right. The bird is there. Okay. And now these men were directly under the power line where the sparrow was trapped. Okay, children. Up till here, I end with part 4. Hope, children, you are enjoying this story. Keep on reading this story so that your reading skill improves. Children, please do like and subscribe my video. I'll be carrying on with the same very chapter in part 5. Till then, children, take care. Bye.